Two chambers of Congress passed a budget bill in record time a few weeks before the Christmas break.
House Speaker Sonny Belmonte earlier said the swift passage of the budget is a vote of confidence on the president.
Budget Secretary Butch Abad, meanwhile, said the early passage of the budget will ensure the immediate implementation of government's priority projects.
And we will bring this to you live over there at Malacañang. The signing again of the 2012 budget. That again is 1.8 trillion pesos. Present, of course, Senators Edgardo Angara, Franklin Drilon, Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, and of course, members of the cabinet, the official family of the President, Vice President Jejomar Binay, also in attendance.
Okay, we had Majority Leader Neftali Gonzalez saying that the early signing of the budget bill into law would give the palace enough time to front load funds to agencies and to pump prime the economy. We've had a couple of years before when the budget was reenacted, so this was done in record time. Sounds good to the business community as well.
They made sure they were able to pass this bill, both houses of Congress. I'm sure you have a very happy president. It's not, again, as Ron said, a reenacted budget. As a matter of fact, it's a 1.8 trillion peso budget that government can spend for the year 2012.
Most appropriate to pursue his vision for country. Mr. President, just a while ago, we acknowledged the presence in the audience of various sectors represented here today and who have joined your administration in a strategic alliance toward nation building. They include the Muslim and indigenous peoples, women farmers, agro-industrial workers, business leaders, local government officials, foreign development partners, and civil society leaders. Before I proceed further, may I have the honor of introducing the distinguished personalities seated with the President at the table. We have Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile. We have Speaker Feliciano Belmonte Jr. Senator Franklin Drilon, Chairman of the Committee on Finance, is here. We also have Senator Edgardo Angara. We also have Congressman Joseph Emilio Abaya, Chairman in the Lower House of the Committee on Appropriations. We have Majority Floor Leader Boyet Gonzalez. Deputy Speaker Maria Isabel Climaco is here. Congresswoman Telma Almario is here. Our Executive Secretary, Jojo Ochoa, is here. And Secretary Florencio Butz Abad is here. Vice President Binay, as I said earlier, is also here. May we now invite the other members of Congress to come and please join the President and the leaders of Congress as witnesses to this auspicious occasion. Salamat sa inyo. Oh, what's your stand? What's your stand? Hi, Bong. Ayaw eh. At this point, may we request the President to now proceed in signing this piece of landmark legislation. Upon signing of the President, ladies and gentlemen, this new law shall be known as Republic Act 10155, based on House Bill number 5023, entitled An Act Appropriating Funds for the Operation of the Government of the Republic of the Philippines from January 1, to December 31, 2012, and for other purposes. We're certainly happy that Vice President Jojo Marbina is coming. How about a big hand for the country's national leadership? Thank you, distinguished members of Congress. What's your step on it? I'm done. What's your step?